Hey, this is Paul from Wondershare MobileTrans, and you'll have seen over the past couple of days and weeks that the Galaxy S23 Ultra has been released into the wild, and hopefully you've seen our video about how you can transfer your data from an old Samsung device to this new Galaxy S23 Ultra. If you haven't, don't worry about it, because what we'll do is put a link to that in the description below. In today's video though, what we'll do is we will put the Galaxy S23 Ultra and the iPhone 14 Pro head to head, because they've been rivals for so long, but now who comes out on top? That is the question. If you're new here though to the channel, then why not hit the subscribe button, notification bell, and like the video as well. And let's get into today's video. Samsung and iPhone have been rivals for what seems like forever, and every single year they try and outdo each other with who has the better device. Is it iPhone? Is it Samsung? There's always an argument about it. So let's have a look at what we think is the better device. And first of all, let's have a look at the shape of the phones. The S23 Ultra and the iPhone 14 Pro Max are tipped as two of the best phones ever released, and you can see that with the shape, the design, and everything about them. The design of these phones give off an air of elegance and class, and nevertheless, there are some subtle differences between their looks. For example, the S23 Ultra is distinguished by the eye-catching Infinity O display, which includes a built-in camera to produce stunning visual effects and does away with the need for distracting with notches or even dynamic islands. The edges of the Galaxy S23 Ultra are slightly curved and comes in some really exciting colours. However, on the other hand, you have the iPhone 14 Pro Max, which have a slight design change this year and of course did away with that notch and is now notchless because it has that dynamic island. It's also flat in appearance and is nice and squared off, and a lot of people prefer this when they're holding it in their hand rather than having anything that is a little bit curved. And you have a choice of colours for the 14 Pro Maxes as well, which actually gives you an even harder choice when trying to pick between these phones. But all things considered, both these phones in terms of design look absolutely fantastic, and really it comes down to personal preference when you're picking up these phones. Do you want a bit of a bigger, chunkier phone in terms of the S23 Ultra, or do you want something that is squared off with a dynamic island in that top screen as well? You need to decide for that one yourself, but let us know in the comments below what you prefer. Now, this is what OS do you think is better? So what operating system? Android was One UI in Samsung, or is iOS 16 the one for you? Android 13 working through One UI has been around for quite some time now, and it is taking a bit of time to be refined, but now works really well. In this addition of One UI, the animations are quicker, everything opens a little bit smoother, and it feels nice and optimized for that Galaxy S23 Ultra. And to be fair, there aren't really any sort of problems whilst using this UI. Along with that, you get a little bit more customization when using Android. So if you like to customize your devices and phones, then Android might be a choice that you might want to pick up. On the other hand, you have iOS 16, which of course has been around through every generation of iPhone. iOS, when it was released, was revolutionary, and now they are on the version 16 of this OS, and it is obviously very optimized for iPhone, and everything works incredibly quick. It has great additions like Face ID, it has really stable apps, and of course the software just works perfectly. However, this year it has been a little bit buggy, iOS 16, with the release of the 14 Pro Max. And iOS 16 is customizable, but nowhere near as customizable as an Android device. So this is something to consider when you're picking up a phone. With the Galaxy, do you want Android and One UI and that customization and that stability, or do you like iOS 16, which is trying to work so well on an iPhone? Again, that choice is up to you, but let us know which one you prefer. When we come to cameras on these phones, they are both some of the best cameras you can get in a smartphone on the market. Samsung and iPhone are known for taking some of the best photos out there, but now, are there any differences between those two cameras? The Galaxy S23 Ultra has a 200 megapixel primary sensor and can zoom in up to 100 100 times, and it can also do 8K video recording, which is something that the iPhone actually cannot do. The 14 Pro Max does have that triple camera setup with a 48 megapixel main camera and can record 4K videos, but doesn't have that ability to zoom in 100 times, where we're stuck with 3x optical zoom, so you cannot get anywhere close as to what the Galaxy S23 Ultra can. On both of these devices, you do have portrait video and portrait photos, and they do look slightly different. Personally, I feel Samsung is a little bit oversaturated, where iPhone is a little bit closer to real life. However, then I think that Samsung takes better low light photos than the iPhone, so it's quite a difficult choice. But because these cameras are so great, no matter what phone you go with, I think you'll be happy with your choice. If you have an iPhone and you want to switch to that Galaxy S23 Ultra, then you might want to take over all of your data. And there are a couple of ways to do that. But first, let's talk to you about a piece of software called MobileTrans. The MobileTrans software allows the selective transfer of various types of phone data in more than 6,000 mobile phones. And it can be Android to iPhone or iPhone to Android. You can transfer videos, data, messages, chats with just a few clicks, and it is seamless and works really quickly. It needs no technical knowledge at all. You can move from Android to iPhone, iPhone to Android, and as well as phone transfer, MobileTrans can also support the backup of your phones as well on this software, so it is a really good piece of software. But let me show you how you would use it. Download MobileTrans to your computer and then launch it from that home screen. And then click on the phone transfer selection and then just click on phone to phone transfer. You then need to connect both your phones to the PC using that USB cable, and your iPhone will be the source, whilst if you are getting that Galaxy, that Samsung will be the destination. And if you get it wrong, you can just flip it in the middle. Now from that interface, you just need to select all of the data that you want to transfer from that one device over to another. Once you've got your data ready, go and click start, and then what you'll have to do is just sit and be patient with the process, because this can take some time. However, once it is finished, all of your data will have been transferred from your iPhone to the Galaxy S23 Ultra. You will of course need a computer from this, which if you don't have one can be slightly frustrating, but if you have a computer, the good thing about MobileTrans is it's quick, it's easy to use, it can transfer everything at the click of one button, and it requires no technical even knowledge to get this started, so go ahead and try MobileTrans. The next option we have to help you transfer data is to use something that Samsung have developed called Samsung Smart Switch. Smart Switch is Samsung's native data transfer solution that facilitates the migration of data from an old phone to a new Samsung Galaxy phone. It allows you to transfer phone data like contacts, media, call logs, and more, and is 100% free to use. So let me show you how you can use this to transfer your data from the iPhone to the Samsung. Open the Smart Switch app on your S23 and tap Receive Data. Then select iPhone/iPad. Connect the iOS device with the S23 Ultra using that lightning cable. Next, you need to trust the device on your iPhone and tap Next to the Samsung phone. Then select the type of data you want to transfer from the iPhone to the Galaxy phone. Smart Switch will then begin the transfer process, and it should finish the operation within a few minutes. Just ensure you don't disconnect the phone during this transfer. There are always pros and cons of using Smart Switch, and one of the negatives is that the transfer of data is a little bit limited in what you can pick. However, the positives are it's a straightforward process, it works with all iPhones and Samsung phones, and you don't even need a PC. Next is something that might be quite surprising, but you can actually transfer data from your iPhone to the Samsung phone just using the USB cable. Using this method, documents, videos, and photos are all supported, and you'll need a computer. So let me tell you how you would do it. Connect your iPhone to the PC using its USB cable and then trust it. Launch the Windows Explorer and click on your iPhone icon from the left-hand side of the screen. Then you need to locate the files that you want to transfer to the Samsung phone, then drag and drop it into a folder. You just need to make sure the S23 Ultra is connected to the PC and trusted. And once it is, just then finally drag and drop the files to that Samsung device. The pro of this is that you don't need any sort of software, you just need your PC, and it's fairly straightforward though. And the negatives are that it can take quite a long time, and you risk having some data corruption in this method as well, but I will leave it up to you to decide what method you think is best. And what we want to talk to you about now is using Google Drive to move some of your data. Google Drive is a fantastic way of moving data. You just need to download the app onto both of your phones, and you can upload any documents, photos, videos that you want to that Google Drive backup. So let me show you what you would do to use Google Drive to help move some of your files. But remember, some of the files that you can move are limited to photos, videos, contacts, and other things like that. But let me show you what you would do to get this started. Open Google Drive on your iPhone and tap on the menu icon on the top left and select the gear icon. By default, Google Drive will back up contacts, calendars, photos, and videos. On your S23, sign into the same account you used to back up your iPhone data and restore it to the new backup. You will, however, need to purchase more storage from Google if you have over 15 gigabytes of data that you want to transfer. It is, however, really straightforward and easy to use. And before we finish, let me tell you about a campaign that we're running where if you share your opinion, you could win yourself $50. For a chance to win that $50, check the link in the description below and feel free to join in. And we will also be running a new campaign soon where you can get 20% off a MobileTrans subscription. So make sure you keep your eyes peeled to get that great discount. That's all for today's video, and we've given you a bit of a head-to-head between the Galaxy phone and the iPhone. So what do you think is better? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell as well. And if you do all of that, we'll see you in the next video.